Hi, I'm Dominic Robson-Neal.
I'm Zell Folks.
And this is Inside the Ropes
Boxing Show.
All right.
We have another very, very exciting episode of Inside the Rope. I'm here with my co-host, Coach Marlon Clemens. Marlon, what are we talking about today, champ?
Let's talk about the business of boxing, navigating boxing contracts and sponsorships.
All right, well, first of all, boxing business is like no other business in the world. And I was told that a long time ago, and until I actually start doing business with boxing, like doing actually sitting around or with the negotiation part of it, boxing business ain't like no other business. You know what I'm saying? It's a tough business to be in. So, as far as the business of boxing, most fighters know that they know the boxing aspect of it, but they don't know the business of it. You know, that's why a lot of times we saying, well, why this person don't fight that person? Well, it's business, you know. Like I tell people, pro boxing is a business, amateur boxing is a sport. So it's a difference. Now we trying to, as we doing business, we trying to make sure everything is profitable for us, or what we agree upon is after taxes, after everything come out, after everybody's paid, the fighter's still comfortable. You know what I'm saying? Because at the end of the day, that's who's trying to make the money, the fighter.
Right.
You know what I'm saying? But you have a lot of, in boxing, you have a lot of sharks. You got a lot of sharks, a lot of cutthroat. It's a lot of that go into boxing that people don't see. They just see the fights on TV and they, oh man, they fighting. Let's just hook this fight up. Or, you know, the fans, man, won't he fight him? Won't he fight him? Nah, it's business.
Right.
Because it's like, if Zeb had an undefeated prospect, you had an undefeated prospect, right? You done put money into the, you put money into yours, he put money into his. And people say, well, why don't they let them two fight when they only have like about 6 or 7 fights? Why would you put them two together when whoever lose, gonna lose money?
Right.
Their money train is gone. So a lot of times people won't take the risk. Now, if you have some rich promoters, the ones who really have money, they will be like, okay, let's let them fight now. So if I can see if I have something worthy, there's no need for me to get 20 fights down the line and find out, man, this joker can't fight, or he don't have no heart, or he missing something. You know what I'm saying? When you could have found out 15 fights ago. So that's why you have a lot of, you know, people don't understand the business of it, but it's so much that go on with boxing.
Coming out now is people finding out that actual fighters don't get their total revenue, and they're waiting for the back-end money, and that could be anywhere from months to several years.
You're right. So, like, let's say you had a fight with a big major promotion. They might tell you, all right, the front end, we're gonna give you such and such amount of money up front, the rest coming in. You know, then they tell you some fake pay-per-view numbers. Oh, well, the pay-per-view numbers didn't come out right, so we didn't make nothing off pay-per-view. So you just sitting there stuck like, okay, you're trying to wait for pay-per-view numbers when actually they already know they're gonna tell you the pay-per-view numbers, because you're not privy to go find out really what the numbers were.
Okay.
You know, so it's a cutthroat game, you know. A lot of times a guy call and offer you a fight, he might offer you $5,000 for the fight when the fight was actually worth $12,000. But if you sitting around the gym worrying about how you gonna pay your cell phone bill,
right,
and they call with that offer, you gonna take it.
Absolutely.
You know what I'm saying? Because you broke. So, you know, it's a lot of things that go into negotiating a contract. Because you and Zeb might, let's say I'm the promoter of a fight. You and Zeb say y'all want to fight. Y'all on social media going back and forth. So you say, I want to fight, and he want to fight too. We get back, that's our negotiation. Then he says, man, if y'all don't give me $20 million, I'm not fighting. But it's a non-disclosure act saying we can't talk about what went on in the meeting. So he come back out and get on social media. It looked like he want to fight, but in all actuality, y'all know he don't want to fight. You know what I'm saying? But what fighters don't understand is fighters are their own boss.
Right.
Actually, the manager and the promoter work for the fighter. The fighter is the boss, the employer, the trainer, and all the manager. They're his employees. But a lot of times they don't know that. So, but boxing has been one way so long that the fighters don't go in there and negotiate their purse. They have somebody go in there and do it, when technically they could.
That's what Bud.
That's what Crawford was doing. They thought he was a fool.
Right.
But he was just doing what he was entitled to do. He want to know about this, he want to know about that. Because he wasn't taught that part of the game. You know what I'm saying? So, when people say, oh man, he's trying to go straight to the man.
Right.
But then he went to Arrow 1-on-8. We in charge. Let's make the fight. He told him what he wanted. Arrow gave him exactly what he wanted. The fight happened. We saw, say again.
Y'all see, sorry for cutting you.
All right.
But it just came to my mind when you said Crawford. They was trying to put, what is his name? McGregor.
Oh, but yeah, Crawford and McGregor.
He just turned that fight down.
Yeah, Crawford said, you ain't kicking me.
What does that look like on paper, like far as money wise?
Big. $100 million.
Big. Big time money.
Big money. Super money. Crawford, but it was a two-fight deal. One fight MMA, the next fight boxing.
Oh.
And Crawford's like, man. But then when they said, what if, so the guy asked Crawford, what if they offer you $100 million? So now we talking.
Right.
Yeah, because you never know it. I'll get in there and fight you for $100
million.
So how much of that $100 million
on the front end?
Well, pay-per-view-wise, that's going to sell. So you can't come back and tell me we didn't get pay-per-view numbers, because that fight will sell.
Right.
So, and you think about it, McGregor got, what, Floyd, his biggest payday, right?
Right. Well, that was his biggest payday, too.
He got
$100 million for that.
So, but the way the way McGregor was saying was like, we get $100 for the first one and $100 for the second one. That's crazy money.
Big time money.
Now, what is the term? I know what it is, but I want y'all guys to go into it a little bit. When they say, when they bring the fighters in the back room and say, y'all can sell this fight now. So you remember with the Floyd and McGregor, it was this big tour of them.
Right, going around talking.
Different venues.
Talking foolishness to each other.
Trying to sell the fight and bring all the numbers up. So, what does that look like?
They were the stars globally, so they had to touch different continents to sell that fight. You know, McGregor, he's not from the U.S. You got a big fan base overseas, so you got to promote that over there. Then you got to go to Cali and New York. That's off rip once you come to the United States. So
Texas.
Right. So you're gonna have big promotions, especially whenever you got the number one person from one sport coming to face the top person from another sport. You know, two different fan bases, big time money. What you gotta say about that?
Well, sometimes some fights gonna sell whether they talk trash to each other or not. You know what I'm saying? Sometimes it looks almost WWE scripted with some of these guys get up there and Talk foolish. Now, you watch some Turkish Ali bouts, right? Man, you don't see them guys over there on the stage talking to each other. They get up there, they get respectful.
Right.
Because the money already there. They ain't got to sell the fight. The fight going on anyway. Man already paid for the fight. So it's not like they got to try to sell it. They already got their contract. They know what they getting already. So it's not like they have to get up there and I gotta talk about your mama or belittle you, you know what I'm saying? Or call you a man, a ninja, and all that. You ain't gotta do all that.
Right.
You know what I'm saying?
And that's also getting kind of played out, you know?
It's been played out. You know what I'm saying? Come on, man.
Keep it above.
You gonna mess your money up and fight him outside the ring?
Right.
Right up here, you gonna...
It doesn't make sense.
Right. Get it. Do all that talking you... When all that talking you doing, just in the ring. The ring gonna tell the story.
I blame Mike Tyson for this. Everybody wanna be Iron Mike.
Everybody ain't Iron Mike.
Right.
Everybody ain't Iron Mike. Mike
would do some things.
But Mike would fight you on the street for real.
Right.
He would fight you on the street for real. Yeah, Mike would put them hands and paws on you outside. Wherever you wanted that, that's right. Where he's going to give it to you.
Right.
You know, so. Yeah, that's good. But boxing, like I say, man, you got to be in the game to understand boxing business, because the average business man who has a successful business, he can't just come in boxing and think. They've tried. He can't come in. Look at 50 when he tried to get in boxing.
Right. They ran him out.
Yeah, they ran him out.
Before we go, let's speak about how important it is for the sponsorships.
Well.
And, you know, I mean, the point of a boxer wearing logos on their shorts.
Well, when you see a boxer wearing something, he's getting paid because, or he should get paid because he's representing your brand. Your brand is getting seen on TV. And whether people might not even like your brand, they're going to see it. You know what I'm saying? Just seeing the brand is advertisement. So you're paying. So, you know, the fighter might have a sponsorship packet where he wears all your clothes, he wears all your shoes, he brushes teeth with your toothbrush, whatever. But he's getting sponsored by that. He's getting paid just like any other, like NBA.
Right.
If you remember back in the day, about 10, 15 years ago, Jokers used to write the big name on the back of their back. They used to have the such and such casino.com
right,
in big
right,
black
right,
letters
right.
on the back. Yeah. You know what I'm saying?
Yeah.
They were getting paid for that. You know, so, hey, you want to be exposed. That's the best exposure, especially in a big fight, because right. everybody's going to see it. Mm-hmm. It's like a Super Bowl. They pay for those crazy commercials, right? So even if you got knocked out, you had your name on the bottom of somebody's shoes, and he was knocked out, they could read your brand. You know what I'm saying? So so whatever, sometimes any publicity that's seen on TV is good publicity.
Right.
Yeah, so. Well, this has been another episode of Inside the Ropes. Y'all have a very good weekend, good day. And the Better Beef fight is coming up. Also,
Better Beef,
I got them too. All the boys in the gym say Bibble. And Bibble gonna get slapped. Remember I told you right here, he can't run for so long, right. Gonna get slapped.
I got them going out in 11.
Secondly, November 2nd, we have an amateur show at South Carolina State First. Amateur show thrown at the HBCU. Come out, give us your support and help these fighters, take care of these fighters while they're young. Or know these fighters and get to know them while they're young, so when they get over and big, you're not just running over to them like, hey, I remember you when you was a kid. Support them now.
Right.
All right, thank you.